Triangulation is one of my favorite techniques in genetic genealogy, and today we're going to have a head-to-head matchup between 23andMe and MyHeritage to see which one has the better triangulation tool. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your family stories along the way. Triangulation is an excellent technique whereby you can identify groups of people who probably share a common ancestor. In order to triangulate, you need at least three people. And person A has to match person B has to match person C, and person C has to match person A, all on the same segment. And that's the really important part. It's not just that they match, you have to match on the same segment. And that forms this little triangle where everybody matches each other in that same spot. Because of this, it usually means that that segment of DNA was passed on from a common ancestor. Now, several websites have different tools that you can help triangulate, but 23andMe and MyHeritage have some very particular tools in regards to triangulation, and I wanted to compare them head-to-head today. So I've selected four things in regards to triangulation, and we're going to look at how 23andMe does that and how MyHeritage does that. Let's get started. The first one is whether or not the website notifies you about triangulation. So what do I mean by this? Well, if we go over to 23andMe and we look at one of our matches, that would be me and this other person here, then we're going to see this list of shared matches. Now, that list of shared matches is anybody that both of us share some amount of DNA with. And you can see that there is percentages in the other two columns of how much each one of us shares. But what's important is this last column, because in this shared DNA column, it tells us yes or no. And whenever it has a yes, that means that we have a triangulated segment. So 23andMe is telling us, hey, these three people together, they triangulate. So let's look at MyHeritage. Do they notify us about triangulation? Well, first off, when we go to a match and we click on that match page, we get to a page similar to this where we have the match and ourselves together. And then if we look down, we'll find a shared match list of all the people that we share DNA in common with. Now, this has been the same as what we saw in 23andMe. So let's see about notification. If we look over all the way to the other side, we see, yes, they have a way that they actually identify triangulation. It's like these chromosomes with a box around it, indicating that there is a triangulated segment. So both 23andMe and MyHeritage notify their customers about triangulation, and they do it in a really good way that's easy to see. So this is a tie. 23andMe gets 1 point, and MyHeritage gets 1 point. Good job to both of you. Now that we've been notified about triangulation by each one of the websites, what do we need to do next? Well, remember, one of the things that I told you about triangulation that's important is that we match each other on the same location. So, does the website tell us what that location is? Well, let's take a look to see if they identify the triangulated segment. On 23andMe, whenever we click on one of those yeses, it's going to go to this page. And we can see that this has the triangulated group. There's the three people being compared. And the next thing is, as you look down, you might say, hey, these look like they're probably the triangulated segments. And, well, you might be right, but you also might not be. Because what's being compared here by these two lines is two of the three comparisons that we need. So we need person A compared to person B, and that's being done. And we need person C being compared to person A, and that's being done. But what we don't have here is we don't have person B being compared to person C. So I put a question mark on these triangulated segments because I don't know if these are being triangulated yet. So 23andMe doesn't tell you the specific segment that is triangulated. What about MyHeritage? Well, on MyHeritage, when we click on one of those little indications of a triangulated segment, it goes to this page. And you can see that we have the triangulated group here. And as we look over, they actually identify with that box the triangulated segment. In this case, there's just one triangulated segment on chromosome number one for these three people. So it's very easy to see right off where that triangulated segment is. I can hover over that triangulated segment and get some more information, but MyHeritage actually tells you where that triangulated segment is. So MyHeritage, they get the win for this category. And the score now is MyHeritage 2 and 23andMe 1. Now, one of the things I like to do is I like to do a lot of the things manually myself and actually see how things are working. 23andMe and MyHeritage have their own algorithms, how they match people up, and how they do triangulation, which the triangulation part is very straightforward. So what I want to do is I want to see, is there a way that I can verify that triangulated segment? Is there a way that I can see for myself that this segment is triangulated? Well, let's take a look at 23andMe. Now remember, we started off with this page where we have our three people in our triangulated group, and 23andMe told us that this group is triangulated. We also had these two segments, one on chromosome 7 and one on chromosome number 10, that look like they may triangulate. Well, if we go to the next match and we actually look at person B matching person C, we've already done person A matching B and person C matching A. So this is the third step, is person B matching person C. I'm not one of these two people. These are the other two matches. If we look, we can see that yes, on chromosome number 7 right at the beginning and on chromosome number 10 right there in the middle, they both match each other. So this is a triangulated segment. Actually, this is two triangulated segments between these three people. And I verified that by looking at all three of those matches, A to B, B to C, and C to A. That's how you verify it. What about with MyHeritage? Well, on MyHeritage, we go back to the chromosome browser and we see that, hey, you have to be one of the kits. So unless you have kits from various people that you're trying to triangulate that you control, then you're not actually going to be able to verify this triangulation. You can't look at B versus C. Like I'd said before though, MyHeritage actually identifies that triangulated segment for you. And so you're going off of your trust in their algorithm and their analysis of that, which is probably perfectly fine. I just like to do that extra step to verify it myself. So in this case, I'm going to give 23andMe the win for being able to verify that triangulated segment. And we have a score of tied again, 2-2. Let's see on our fourth one, which company is going to come out on top. Remember at the beginning, I said that triangulation, you need to have at least three people. But you don't have to have just three people. You can actually triangulate with more than three people. And we want to see if either one of these companies allows us to triangulate more than three people. In order to do this, we're using the chromosome browser and we're using the advanced feature where you can select different people. Now on 23andMe, this is what it looks like. And you can see that we can actually select up to six different people. And what's cool about this in conjunction with the last one is it doesn't have to be me or one of the kits I manage. It only has to be one of the kits of people that I've shared DNA with. So I can do triangulations for other groups of people besides just myself. And this can be up to six people. Now you're going to have to go through and do lots of different matches to be able to confirm all the way through, but six people's quite a lot. Over at MyHeritage, we see that there is the capability to do eight people. Now, one of these has to be yourself, but you can have seven other people that you can see whether or not you triangulate with. So in grading this, how am I going to decide the winner? And this was really tough, but since I'm only doing whole points, I'm honestly going to have to give this to 23andMe for the win, because I like the ability to triangulate other people as well as those kits that I manage myself. So even though they only do 6 as opposed to 8, the fact that they allow you to triangulate other people and not just yourself, I'm gonna give that as the bonus for it. But this doesn't mean that MyHeritage doesn't have a great triangulation system. So overall, 23andMe wins it in my book, but it's a really close second with MyHeritage. Now, if you would like to know more about triangulation, then maybe you should look at one of these videos up here that I talk in different ways about how you can triangulate your DNA. If you have any questions about triangulation, put it in the comments below. And be sure to subscribe to this channel and click on the bell so that you can be notified about upcoming episodes.